Dear students, good morning. I am Dr. Kundangar from Civil Engineering Department. The topic for today is dull conservation, the achievements and failures. All of you know that dull is a focal point, a lake which is of great importance to our valley. As you know, being engineering students, the Dal Lake is not only the focal point or focal central point for this tourism or recreation, but is also one of the sources of our potable water. It is one of the important water sources for the city dwellers as we harvest waters from Dal and Nigin Lake. So therefore, it becomes imperative for us that we have to see about its conservation, about its preservation, and overall, if we have done something for last so many years for its conservation, what are the achievements and what are the failures? Because you know, the scientist is basically, the job of a scientist is basically to collect the basic infrastructure material for the conservation. That is, what is the water quality, existing water quality, the incoming ingress of sewages, to quantify the sewage, to see the characteristics of the sewage, what is the kind of status of flora, fauna of the lake. And when all these parameters are collected together, they are being considered by a planner. The planner, after assessing the parameters, designs a conservation plan. And it is the engineers concerned who have to execute on the ground the plan which has been prepared by the planners. So therefore, there are three components. The basic is scientist who provides, just we see in civil engineering, one gives the, we need sand, we need bricks, we need cement. Those raw materials are like scientists are providing those materials. The planner or who frames up the plan, collects this data and frames a conservation plan. Then the actual execution lies on the shoulders of engineers, whether it is a cement engineer or whether it is a mechanical engineer or what we call as environmental engineer. They all have to come together and execute the chalk dugout plan. So let us see about Dal Lake. The Dal Lake pollution and encroachments have been a subject of numerous reports and hot topics on social media also, which have gone to extent of predicting a short lifespan for the lake. There can be no denial to the fact that Dal Lake has fallen victim to human greed, which has led the lake undergo through various maladies of human incursions. Large areas of the lake have been reclaimed and converted into floating gardens and subsequently into permanent land masses, as you see in the picture. Lily pads with ulterior motives, unabated construction within and around peripheries, entry of sewage from the immediate catchment with an average of 156 tons of phosphorus and 244.18 tons of nitrogen which enters the lake. This results in serious weed infestation with frequent algal blooms followed by sudden fish kills. Now here are the, some pictures we have taken. What is happening on the banks of the Dal Lake? You see lots of cow dung is being put on a boulevard road on the banks. This gentleman who is a lake dweller, is extending the bunding for his farms so that it goes on encroaching the lake by not by inches, by say by yards every day. And then you see inside the lake we have floating gardens. These are the natural floating gardens which are being converted into first huts and then permanent establishments. This was the previous condition. This is not the condition now, but what it was basically, it is in front of Nishad. You can see the camel bridge or auto bridge, we call it, is here. These are all these surface drains which enter into the lake. This was the condition when the dredging started after that. The achievements of LARA. LARA is Lakes and Waterways W30. For the restoration and conservation of the lake are briefly summarized. I would like to say that these observations are based on the research topics of my two candidates who belong to SM College of Engineering. The catchment area of Dal Lake is about 375 square kilometers, has been divided into 12 micro watersheds for treatment order to control the non-point source of pollution and silt following into the lake from the catchment. Dal has basically 370 kilometers of catchment area. Catchment area means the forests, the mountains that we have all around Dal Lake forms the catchment area. And due to the soil erosion, lots of silt, we will come to that also, about 80,000 tons of silt per annum is entering Dal Lake into Dal every year. Whatever the silt is coming, under the Tokyo plan, it was designed that a settling basin is constructed at the mouth of the or the tail end of the Tailbal Nala, or entry of the before entering Dal Lake, we have a settling basin where all the silt which comes to the lake, about 80,000 tons per year, that is being trapped in this settling basin. It has been commissioned in order to increase the water expense of the lake. 28 lakhs cubic meters of solid moss within the lake, including the area from Nishad to Habak, has been dredged out. And the water expense of around 2 square kilometers has been added to the lake water. Now, this is the condition which was before dredging. You can see the cows are grazing. This has become a total land mass on the periphery of the Dal, which is in front of Nishad. These I have shown in the previous picture also. These are the drains, open drains, which enter into Dal Lake. This was the condition before the dredging was initiated. Now, here are two photographs. This is how suction cutter dredger has been introduced into Dal Lake way back about 20 years. Now, after dredging out, you can see the waters are clean. This is a reclaimed, what was reclaimed is now an open water body. And we as a scientist have also done what are the impacts, that is, what was the condition of water before dredging and after dredging, and what are the impacts of environmental impact assessment studies have also been taken into consideration. You can see again another view of the same place. This was before dredging. This was a land mass, and after dredging, this is the open water surface. Now, what happened that unfortunately, dividing is being done in Dal Lake for so many years. It is a regular engineering ongoing work with the Dal Lake. As you know, the weeds or water plants, they grow up in any lake because of the fact, since sewage comes into Dal Lake, it has nitrates, it has phosphorus, it has so many other nutrients, a sort of a fertilizer it acts, which gives tremendous growth to the aquatic plants or what we call as weeds. Now, this weeding, if when it was observed that when weeding took place massively, at the same time, what happened? The weeds came, which were rooted out, then nutrients which were locked up by these aquatic plants, they got released. Result, we had a red algal bloom all over the Dal Lake. The algal blooms are a result of what we have found, a result of excessive dividing, which release nutrients, or wherever there are stagnant pockets in Dal Lake, you will find that we have these algal blooms. In order to combat algal blooms, we have what we see, the fountains. These are not fountains, these are basically the aerators, the floating aerators. 75 floating aerators have been installed in the stagnant pockets of the lake to combat the triggering of eaglenite bloom. As a result of this what we call aeration, more the oxygen we give, less the carbon dioxide, and the bloom is cut off. And the menace which Dal Lake is facing is an exotic aquatic plant, what we call as lily pads, water lilies. They have grown to such an extent that about, I have been told that nowadays, about 2 square kilometers of Dal Lake in front of Char Chinari has been occupied by these aquatic weeds. You can see that about 2.9 square kilometers area has been cleared, but still these weeds, every year you will find that open water bodies up to 2, 5, 3 kilometers are being covered by these. So it has become a permanent nuisance for the lake conservation plan. Now, what has been done? Dal has 2 exit channels. The hydrology of Dal Lake is also peculiar. It would have 2 outlets for Dal Lake. One is Nala Amir Khan. Another is Dal Gate. You can see this is a view of Nala Amir Khan, where you can see outflow channel of Nala Amir Khan has been improved to enhance the carrying capacity of from 150 to 1330 cubics, thereby improving hydraulic management of the lake. As you know, everybody knows, we had what we call as a zigzag serpent-like canal, exit canal, which was running through the heart of the downtown Srinagar, what we call as Nalai Mar. Since the closure of the Nalai Mar, we have instead of a road now, it was decided that a cut will be given somewhere near Barinambal Lagoon to connect it with the river Jhelum. So 468 meter long cut and cover conduit linking Barinambal Lagoon, what we call as Bob Dam, with river Jhelum, that has been commissioned with the aim of improving water circulation of the lake instead of Nalai Mar. As you know, that I have told you that how much ingress due to the massive development around the Dal Lake, all the sewage which enters into Dal Lake has created a havoc to the Dal Lake. With the ingress of the sewage, what happened? It was decided that 5 sewage treatment plants, capacity of 36.1 MLD of sewage per day, have been commissioned at Habak, Lam, Hazratbal, Barinambal, Nalai Mir Khan, besides 11 intermediate pumping stations to treat these sewage water which is entering into Dal Lake. This is a glimpse of the sewage treatment plant. The one thing I would like to mention, that this sewage treatment plant, which has been recommended, is FAB based. FAB is fluidized Arabic bacteria. This is the an idea of how this sewer line along the Dal Lake all around and Nagin has been laid down as per the plan. Under sewage scheme of Dal and Nagin Lake, total trunk sewer laid is These are 23.94 kilometers. The works which have been done on this is, just have a look. The sewers are laid. The trunk sewer is also laid. The authority has laid laterally secondary sewers of total length of 73.64 kilometers so far, leaving a balance of 4.158 kilometers, which is in progress. This is as per the what we have received the information of LADA. For house connectivity in the catchment, STP Hazrabal, Habak and Lom, remodeling of drains 36.363 kilometers sand completed with a balance of 2.763 kilometers. Again, these are the figures given by the concerned department, that is LADA. Now we had in Dal Lake, we have the peculiarity of Dal Lake is again, we have 90,000 people living within the lake in the small islands, what we call as hamlets. And under the rehabilitation program, it is decided that some of them will be taken out of the Dal Lake and rehabilitated somewhere else to reduce the carrying capacity, to increase the carrying capacity of Dal Lake and to reduce the pressure on Dal Lake pollution. So about 1300 families with 650 structures have been settled in the various colonies developed by erstwhile UED and LADA prior to this project. This was the fisherman colony at Habak 20 years back. Now it is an open water body. The houseboats which had come very close to near Dal Gate have been pushed back after carrying out dredging in the backwaters and creating a water expanse and the shoreline to enable the authority to connect these houseboats with the sewage line. Again, I am repeating, these are the informations given by the concerned department. So I don't claim to be whether they are correct or they are incorrect. Salt waste being collected from hamlets, houseboats on regular daily basis and is being brought to the shore for ultimate disposal by SMC, Srinagar Municipal Committee. Now see that we have Northern Foreshore Road, we have also the these are the buffer zones and detention ponds, because we have another menace of aquatic plant that is known as Azolla. In order to arrest that incoming Azolla, these detention ponds have been created on the periphery of the Dal Lake or Northern Foreshore Road. Now everybody says, despite the various measures which we have mentioned just now, there is no appreciable change in water quality. Instead, the same is deteriorating day by day and the lake continues to be on ailing bed. So our second part is, these were the achievements which we discussed just now as per the information of the LADA. Now practically speaking, although these measures have been taken, yet the Dal Lake waters are still polluted. They don't show any improvement in any way, instead deteriorating every day. Now the second part is, what are the failures then? Why have we not achieved the, let us come to those points. Although the conservation measures in the catchment by way of afforestation, massive plantation and that of engineering measures through construction of check dams are going on since decades, yet no non-community involvement. These are the points, failures, non-community involvement, non-existence of forage production through silvi pasture, pasture and farmer development and farmer fodder development is totally missing, which otherwise result in massive grazing by the sheep and goats in the upper catchment areas. As we have just now shown, the settling basin has been commissioned for 40 years back. Despite this fact, settling basin at the entry point of Dal Lake has been commissioned decades back, and since the large quantity of silt and sediment has accumulated. You see, for last 40 years, the silt is coming. it is going on increasing the level of the settling basin. Result, the settling basin 2 is almost filled up. It has not been dredged out since. Since it has not been dredged out, so therefore the excess of silt again goes to overflows the settling basin, so it goes into the Dal Lake. The recent desilting and dredging of tail of Tailable Nala, there is a canal which is known as Tailable Nala, which has been dredged out, rather not dredged out, it has been by JCBs, it has been cleaned. It has resulted, without studying the environment impacts, have resulted in invasion of exotic, another weed which is Azolla, has come up after this desilting, which often engulfs the entire Hazable basin of the lake, probably due to release of nutrients from the Nala bed and their entry in the lake. So therefore, if we had to take any engineering measure, if we were to take any of the options in the Dal Lake, which we have to take environment into consideration. We have to see the impacts of that activity. If you go around Boulevard, you will see number of gates are erected on the forum side of the Dal Lake, all along Boulevard. These were meant for improving the water and stopping the inflow of nutrients from the agricultural fields or these gardens from the on the periphery of Dal Lake, whatever agricultural activity is going on. But if you see them, they are defunct. They are not working. With result, the sewage, including the nutrients, including all these filth, enters into Dal Lake all around the boulevard. We were discussing just now Bayarinamal conduit cover, which has been given a cut. Again, it is defects. The Bayarinamal cover and conduit cut of draining the surplus water from the lagoon to Jhelum is also non-functional, and such no flushing of lake or lagoon takes place. The lagoon as such has turned it into a cesspool. Although the decades of old dividing practices through mechanical and manual methods is now regular feature, the same remains confined to peripheral areas of the lake only, while the massive weed infestation continues to be a perpetual problem in the interior of the lake. What I mean to say is that dividing is being done by engineers, no doubt, but only on the what we call peripheries, on the boulevard side of front of the Dal Lake, not inside. So therefore, it is only cosmetic experiment or cosmetic work they are doing, which has not given any substantial results. The second part of the lake is